Hey guys, X-Dark Soldier here, and I am back with more Shocktober, and I've got the park, and wow, the first little bit I played of it, yeah, it's got some promise. So let's just continue this going for now, and see what this creepy-ass game has to offer.
Come out, sweetie.
That's... Thought working in park for a summer would be a lot of fun, but the end of the season here really drags. There aren't that many tourists around, and so most of the staff spend their days standing around, whatever the fuck that is, Googling? And most of that, or gossiping, okay, most of that gossip is about Chad, I mean Steve. See, even I'm starting to call him Chad, and I went to school with the guy. It's that goddamn suit. In the beginning, it was a laugh. Steve, the local lush, as Chad, the chipmunk, child-friendly mascot at Atlantic Island Park, lock up your daughters and all of that. But the more he wears that suit, the weirder Steve is getting. First, it was little things, like if he's going to change out of the suit at work or taking it home with him every day. But then I saw him at Susie's Diner still wearing it, and it wasn't even work day. Some of the staff complained discreetly to park management about the smell, and I saw him walking and talking with Mr. Weister, the owner, one day, but nothing seems to have changed. The suit still smells like a carcass whenever Steve walks by, and apparently Steve has picked up some new skills since the last time I saw him. Puking and up in a gutter outside the Cisco station? Because he sure as hell can carve a mean ice sculpture. Those shapes he makes in the ice, though, they give me the creeps. Steve came by the booth today, lucky me, and he just hung around for a while. I couldn't really tell because of the suit, but it seemed like he was trying to... was staring at me? Damn. Okay. I like Layers of Fear where you could actually change the text over, and I don't know if you can on this one.
Wait, Callum!
Ah! God damn it! What creepiness.
Come out, sweetie.
This way, Mommy.
Sorry I couldn't finish that. Kinda got spooked of...
Callum?
I wanna catch you. Take you home, to be honest.
Come back. Constant crashes and 80s music. Guess it floats someone's boat. Callum, tell Mommy where you are.
What the fuck? What in the fuck?
Callum, where are you?
Francis Dufresne, October 25th, 1976, job title department, laborers working on the crane, supervisor Richard Stapleton. Witness Lawrence Creed and Michael Brunsworth. Brief description: accident. Incident during the transport of the bumper cars into the arena. One of the straps attaching a load to a truck came untied, causing a cascade of bumper cars to fall onto Francis, who was standing directing the driver. Francis was crushed by the weight of the cars. Described any injury. He was killed. Injured employee, see your doctor. Yes. Did you file an employer's portion of the workers' compensation form? Yes. Dexter, truck driver, claims to have seen someone on the back of the load undoing the straps. Nobody else reported seeing that. The sheriff has requested that Dexter provide them with urine samples. What could have been done to prevent the accident? Double checking the straps. Transit should be mandatory. And drug screenings for all drivers. Have the unsafe condition been corrected? No. Whoa, what? What the fuck? No, whoa!
Callum? Tell mommy where you are!
Yeah, Callum?
Don't be afraid.
Yeah, Callum, please come home.
It's a matter of public record that I am a failure as a mother. Once, when Callum was very small, I left him asleep in the car while I ran an errand. Don't even remember what it was. When I came back, the sheriff was standing next to the car, watching my boy through the window. I didn't like what I saw in his eyes. Judgment. He wrote me the ticket without saying a word. Just the scratch of his pen on the notepad. When he gave it to me, our eyes met. I know what you're going through. My daughter, Helen, she just gets some help. Help was a bolt of lightning. Help was 1,000 volts surging through my veins. Help is agony.
What?
I'd rather die. I wanted to scream. I'd rather you pulled your gun and shot me. But instead, my mouth said, yes, Sheriff.
What? Continually delayed by the incompetence of the builders. I cannot. I'm gonna leave it here for a second. I can't read this quite good enough. Yeah, there's no other button to fucking read. Okay. I guess we're going on another creepy ass ride. Up to the Ferris wheel? Because nothing bad ever happens on a Ferris wheel. She should be looking for her fucking son and not riding these goddamn rides. This amusement park.
People come into your life for a reason. Dad used to say that before Mom ran off. After that, he mostly just drank. Things were different for Don and I. When we met, I was sweeping the floor at Susie's diner. He came in with some workers, but he didn't try to flirt or cop a feel like the others. He just ordered a coffee and sat there, watching me. When my shift was over, he offered to walk me home. I don't know how to describe that walk. We talked and laughed and eventually kissed.
Good God.
It felt like love. It felt like a fairy tale. I can't tell you if Callum was made that night or one of the ones that followed. But I think it has to be that night. That one perfect night. Don and I moved in together, but then, well...
This chick's had some tragedy.
According to the supervisor, his safety harness failed when he was working on the top of the Ferris wheel. Don was there one moment, and then gone.
Eek.
Sometimes people leave your life for no reason. I was 3 months pregnant with Callum. Fairy tale fucking over.
Okay. So. Dead husband? Boyfriend? missing son temporarily. Apparently shit mother. What the fuck are you? What the fuck is that guy?
Where are you, Callum? So they are going to close this place down. Doesn't surprise me.
Family, three killed when roller coaster derailed. 14 separate incidents of broken bones and crushed ribs while riding the Octotron. Three suicides from the top of the Ferris wheel. A child severely injured on the escalator. Over a dozen children reported missing in the House of Horrors since its construction. One report of a drowning in the Tunnel of Tells. This place should have been shut down years ago.
Callum, where did you go?
Well, I'm by the Ferris wheel. I guess I'm going to the coaster. I skipped the House of Horrors.
Mommy's coming, Callum!
Let's go towards the crying baby.
Callum? Callum!
Here, child. That's a Ferris wheel piece. What the fuck? Okay, well that's that.
Stop hiding, Callum.
Everybody's watching me, I'm a YouTuber. Let's keep moving.
A lot of people idolize their children. You hear them talking about their kids and just the way they talk, their fucking voices make me want to vomit.
She's getting worse.
My angel likes to read, and little Johnny is so good on the piano. Fuck those people! You give up 9 months of your life carrying them, you traumatize yourself giving birth to them, and then you spend the rest of your life as their slave. Wiping asses, mopping up piss, feeding them, little life-sucking monsters who take and take and take until... We all go insane. Any parent who pretends otherwise is just dishonest. That's called choice supportive bias. I am honest. Callum really grinds my gears, and he owes me everything. Everything. It served the little fuck right if I just abandoned him.
Okay, she's getting worse, guys.
Stay where you are! I always wanted to write this one. Never got around to do it before.
Well, guess what? We're gonna ride this roller coaster into the infinity. Here we go! More insanity from this bitch. And whatever the fuck you are, don't appreciate you.
What do you want?
Exactly.
We need to talk about Callum.
What do you mean? What have you done to him?
That's insulting. You and your boy are everything that this place doesn't want. The antithesis of what we stand for.
Where is Callum?
The poor child. He tried so hard to do what he was taught. He even left you a trail of breadcrumbs. But the park is just so hungry.
Fucking discount Pennywise.
Where my son is?
The witch has him now. Has both of you. No happy ending here, I'm afraid.
The fuck are you, dude?
Just leave me alone.
Fool. You always
were. Okay. Oh, well, shit. Fuck. Okay, when did this turn into Roller Coaster Tycoon from Hell? Okay. We're just gonna... I couldn't read that. Something about Banished. A game I should play. Okay, we're gonna keep moving on. What
the fuck is going on? Oh, fuck. Oh, God. Damn. What the fuck was all that about?
I'm not playing anymore, Callum.
Apparently you are.
The witch awaits. This isn't a game, Callum.
How do I get out of here? Okay, I have a flashlight. Maybe it'll tell me how to activate the flashlight in a second.
Callum has bruises on his arms, finger marks. Someone has been hurting him. I've asked him, demanded really, to know where he got the marks. But he doesn't want to answer me. Something has scared him into silence. He doesn't dare talk. He's been changing too. Something sinister lurks in the darkness behind his eyes. I catch him staring at me at odd moments. In the night, he tosses and turns and cries out words that I cannot understand. When I try to soothe him, he snaps and bites at my fingers. I think he wants to talk to me. I think he wants to tell me. But they are watching him every minute of every day.
They are whispering
to him in his sleep, changing him. They are taking my baby away from me. I can save him. And there will be pain. But I love him, and in the end, he will understand why. Callum, where are you?
Mommy, I'm scared.
Great.
The whole town was shocked by that one. Never found out who did it.
Yesterday evening, visitors to Atlantic Island Park were shocked and horrified by the discovery of a dismembered corpse behind the cotton candy stand. According to the local authorities, the corpse has yet to be identified. However, they have confirmed that the remains appear to have been those of a child. The corpse was discovered by a group of teenagers from Innsmouth Academy who noticed a pair of ravens tugging at something just out of sight behind the shack. Nathaniel Winter, the owner of the Atlantic Park, has released the following statement. It is a true tragedy when something like this happens. Like this occurs, especially in a place that is designed to bring forth happiness and joy. The staff of the Atlantic Park and the park offer their condolences to the family and friends of the victim and will cooperate fully with authorities to bring this case to rest. The Solomon Chronicle will provide daily updates on the story going forward.
I can help you, Callum.
Don't let him take me.
Come back.
Come back, Callum.
I'm not playing anymore, Callum.
Okay. Dear God.
Poor bastard. Who did this to him?
Well. Okay, 1 second, guys. I just killed all my lights. 1 second. Oh, fuck. Jesus Christ. Okay. Sorry, kitty. Scared my cat. Unplugged lights. I rolled a little too far back. Fuck. Okay.
Kala, where are you?
Mark.
This isn't a game, Caleb.
What are you scared of?
Caleb? Caleb!
Keep them away from me.
I can help you, Caleb.
Where am I going?
These are mine.
Are you better off than you were 4 years ago? Reagan, 1980s. Say no to graffiti. Only dead fish follow the stream. Okay. Can't get out of here that way. Can't do anything there.
Don't leave me here, Callum.
What the fuck? Fuck you. What do you want? Fine.
Forgive me, Callum. Sorry.
Future Times, Belly Button is signature personal creator. I believe her name was Mama. I'm not gonna even bother with that.
Forgive me, Kel.
She's lost her goddamn mind. She is. Okay. Jesus Christ. Okay, we're just gonna. Oh, God. Oh God. Oh God.
Oh God, no.
What? When the fuck?
Is a collage.
Okay, guys, that's all the time I got for this episode of The Park for my Shocktober. I jumped pretty fucking hard there. Okay, I will be back with more of this, and thank you so much for tuning in, or, you know, searching, clicking. Okay, you know what, screw it. I'm an old school guy, tuning in, you know, finding, going to my channel, same thing. Okay. Thank you so much for joining me for this adventure that I have found. What the fuck? I don't know. Okay, we'll get back to this here in just a little bit. And please be patient for the next one. Alright, guys. Peace out. Have a good one. And thank you for joining me for Shocktober.
Fucking day! Fuck what you heard! It's what you hearing! It's what you hearing, listen. It's what you hearing, listen. It's what you hearing, listen. X gon' give it to you. Five up, pay you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to you. Knock, knock.